It's very lonely here.
Like the edge of the world.
How long is it till the tide covers the causeway?
Not long.
Is this all there is?
Depends where you're going. It all begins again out there. Perhaps there's a road hidden under the water, lined with drowned souls. There you are. It only rings once. We've been warned. Come on.
Do many people get cut off?
A few. Before they built the lighthouse, this place was a graveyard for ships. There are hundreds of wrecks around here. Why did you come to Jersey in the winter?
I needed to work something out. It can't be very real in the summer.
Everything's real. Reality is total. You see that?
Perhaps.
My family are buried here. We are the last of the Dabanons, my brother George and I. We are all that's left of centuries of Dabanon lives.
That's sad somehow. There are Robinsons everywhere.
Dabanons are like Jersey cows. They don't transplant well. What's your first name?
Annabelle.
Always?
No, usually Anna.
Hugh. Invariably. Welcome to Jersey, Anna.
Glad you asked me here. I'd never have come on my own.
It's one of the most famous burial mounds in Europe. Come on, let's go down. This must have been the grave of some very great chief. Some of these stones weigh 30 tons. Imagine all those hundreds of exhausted men laboring to get them up here on rollers. Life was pretty expendable in 2000 BC.
A lot of them must have died on the way. Wonder if their ghosts are watching us.
Maybe. The past is another country, someone once said. We are the past, Anna. Some part of us is always there.
Look at these marks here on this stone. They're called cup marks.
You find them on monuments all over the world, but no one knows what they are. When we learn to read them, we can go to that country.
Oh, I don't know, really. Bluish green, I think. I've always wanted to wake up in a room of that colour. But my husband likes white everywhere.
So what colour is your bed?
White.
Ah.
But my desk in the library where I work is bluish green and my lamp, so that's something.
It sounds to me that you don't like being at home very much.
Oh, it's not that exactly. It's not what we say, it's what we don't say. After the weekend, it's a relief to go to work.
I suppose that's part of the problem.
Well, David would rather keep me at home. So the library's become a kind of refuge, somewhere where I can think.
What do you think about, mostly? The state of your marriage? Debit and credit balance?
Something like that. Your job's very responsible.
Yes. That's one of the reasons why I do it. Lives depend on my decisions. I enjoy the challenge.
Never mind. The way she looked at him when he went off in the morning.
Was David never like that?
No, never. But you can't change people. After 4 years, I still don't think he really knows what I'm like.
How do you like it?
I'm not sure.
You don't commit yourself easily, do you?
Got the fence.
Well, give me the verdict tomorrow morning. Bye-bye.
Who's that?
Collie. He works with me at the airport. On the ground staff. Not much in his head. Quite a nice kid, though. What were you saying?
Oh, about David. Well, what do you really want? It was a wife, not a person. Just someone to be there. So old-fashioned. They're getting very burnt.
Hold them further away, then. Now what are you doing?
Not managing very well.
I built you the perfect fire, and now you spoil the dinner. You're not much good, are you?
I told you I was a town girl.
We're elemental people. Everything must be you. We cook on fuel from the beach. We gather fertilizer from the sea, which in turn regenerates the earth from whence the sausage that you're about to eat was nourished.
It's ridiculous.
What is?
Well, sausage is being nourished.
Pigs eat too, don't they?
Everything's so deserted. Wonder what they'll do at night. I do wish I didn't have to go back tomorrow. I do hate hurting people. Hugh, do you want me to stay?
That must be your decision.
You needn't wait any longer. I hate farewells. Don't look at me like that. I have to go now. Goodbye.
Don't worry. It's as much my house as his. Come on in.
George! Hello, I'm back.
Oh, so I see.
Anna. This is my brother, George. Anna Robinson. She's going to stay the night.
Really?
I hope it's not inconvenient.
Stay the night, here.
That's what I said. The spare room, clean sheets, fresh flowers, an extra place for dinner.
Well, you better take it upstairs.
Didn't he tell you about his history of the island? Remarkable work. 3 years of intensive study, he's still only halfway through. I'd meant learning old French. Do you know any old French?
No.
No, few people do. Some more wine?
Just a little.
I try to help with the research.
Thank you.
We've always worked very closely together. I deal in antiques, old oak mostly, and silver. Perhaps you'll see my shop in St. Helier.
Yes, Dagonon. It has some very nice branch candlesticks in the window.
Mm, they're not bad. Keep the tourists happy. They don't have good peace when they see one. My best stuff's here, of course. Been with us for generations. We're a very ancient family, you know.
He'll tell you about Sir John now.
Yes, well, why not? You see that brass rubbing behind you?
Mm-hmm.
That's Sir John Lebanon, direct line back to the 13th century.
It looks rather like you.
There is a strong family resemblance between all of us. I brought you up after our parents died. Well, you can tell that, can't you?
He's been a real mother to me.
Yes. Well.
Why are you looking at me? I wish you wouldn't. It makes me feel strange.
To remember everything about you.
La, 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 la. Morning.
Oh. I'm sorry.
Never seen a naked woman before in his life.
Good morning, Annabelle Robinson.
It's mean to laugh at him.
It's his own fault. Anybody else would have had more time.
Or at least brought us 2 cups of tea. You can see the lighthouse. You can see.
All I see is you.
You catch a cold like that.
No breakfast this morning.
You've never done that before.
What?
Brought them home. Brought them home, here, to this house.
For heaven's sake, George.
It's disgusting. In Mother's room. In her bed.
You were probably conceived in that bed.
That's different. You going to marry her?
I don't know. I haven't thought about it.
Well, I'm the head of this household. There are certain standards.
Don't give me that crap. Standards? Blue films after bridge are okay. But making love to a real live woman.
I don't want to find her here when I get back.
I was going to bring you breakfast in bed.
It was lonely up there without you.
We can have it down here now.
It was beautiful, wasn't it?
Yes.
What time do you finish work today?
Not till 5. Will you miss me?
Every minute. Every second.
Come to the airport for lunch.
Yes. I want to be with you always.
Do you remember we met outside the cinema?
Yes. You're Collie.
That's right. And you're?
Anna Robinson.
How do you do? Can I get you a drink?
Thank you. A tomato juice.
Tomato juice, please. Why don't we go and sit over there? Are you going on the 1335?
No, I'm going to have lunch with you.
Oh. Oh, well, he saw you first.
Are you an islander?
By cry, eh? Can't you tell? You mean I sound like an Englishman? Oh, my cry. Thank you. No, I've lived here all my life. My father's one of the centeniers for St. Brelard. Delamar, that's my name.
A centenier?
It's an honorary policeman. It's part-time and they don't get paid for it. But they're allowed to arrest people. They deal with all the crime in their own parish.
Must mean he's very busy.
No, not really. Jersey isn't exactly a hotbed of violence. How much longer are you staying?
Hello.
Hello.
Been waiting long?
A lifetime.
Shall we go?
Bye-bye.
Hugh, what are we going to do? It's impossible here.
George will get used to it.
Well, it isn't just that.
Are you afraid your husband might turn up?
He couldn't accept it, what I said yesterday. Oh, and it was an awful line, and we landed up shouting at each other.
Does he still think there's a chance?
Maybe, I don't really know. He couldn't believe that in 1 week I could meet someone and everything would change.
And has he?
Absolutely, completely. I never felt like that with anyone before. With you, I just want to be with you all the time.
Let's go to Scotland.
I want to make love to you in Scotland.
What a lovely idea. This is it?
This is it. That's the cottage. Used to be the old bakery. We'll be completely on our own.
It's not just an affair, is it?
No. It's a love affair. Come on. Let's tell the Mackays we're here.
So simple. Warmth, good food, and a great big bed. Whenever I went away with David, it was always to a recommended hotel with television in all the rooms.
Nothing like that here. And another thing.
What?
Let's agree not to talk about David anymore.
It's dangerous!
Let's go.
Where are you going, beautiful Annabelle Robinson?
Home. I don't like that place.
You must have more faith in me. Don't ever leave me like that again.
You don't seem to need me. I might not have been there.
I need nobody but you, Anna. Don't ever forget that.
Be like this. Just us.
Get someone. Thank you.
yourself, girl.
Please.
What's the matter?
He's ill. He's terribly ill. You must help me.
Who's ill?
I just get a doctor. Quickly, a doctor. I can't leave him there. I've got to go back.
Douglas, get on the telephone at once for Dr. Irving. Where is he?
He's on the beach by the rocks. Just get a doctor, please.
What was all that about?
Heaven knows. But hurry, man. Get on the telephone to the doctor.
Aye.
Tell him it sounds bad.
Can I give me some assistance?
Well, now, with the sedatives I have given her... Oh, thank you. She should sleep through the night. I'll return for the necessary formalities tomorrow morning.
And what about him in the cottage, Doctor? Is it decent, do you think, with just a sheet on him and him fully dressed?
Oh, Mrs. Mackay, the dead are not able to appreciate consideration about such matters. Sufficient to do your best for her upstairs. As you, like it or not, are responsible for the time being for the both of them. I think you should keep this by till the morning.
What's that?
A certificate of death. Subarachnoid hemorrhage leading to heart failure. He was a fine, big fellow. Strange him dying like that. Ah, it can happen. No warning, no previous heart malfunction. No, no. It's my belief that when you're called, there's no power on earth to interfere.
Yes. Well, now, Doctor, what's to be done with the widow?
Mrs. Robinson will no doubt have to see about the funeral.
Mrs. Robinson?
She's from Weymouth, I understand. Left her husband and ran off with this man.
Well, it's the Lord's judgment, that's what it is.
Now, Biddy. Married or not, she evidently loved the man. I'll say goodnight to you.
It was good of you to come so quickly.
Oh, not a word. I'll look back again in the morning. Good night.
What a thing to happen.
Hey.
Thank you.
Oh, good morning to you. Well, you've been needing Mrs. Mackay to assist you with the laying out.
Thank you. That won't be necessary. You can see there's been a mistake.
Maybe he was just too strong to die.
The doctor should have known what he was about. Him and his philosophizing about the right time to go.
Hey, we'll have a thing or two to tell him when he arrives.
Aye. Come in. Well, good morning.
Good morning. I just came to say that we're leaving.
Leaving?
Yes, we were due to go anywhere. I put the money in there with the keys.
But what about your man? He must be very ill.
No, he's perfectly all right.
Should you not wait for the doctor, Missy?
No, I don't want to see him. He made a mistake. You can tell him that.
But where will you be going?
Home, to Jersey.
Just a minute. You may as well have this. It's no use to us.
Thank you. Goodbye. Get away from that place. They don't understand. You'll be all right when we get home. I wish you would have looked at me. Please, Hugh. You stop it. I'm sorry. Don't worry, I'll get you home. I just want to check the route. Now then, take the A838 to Lag, the 836 to Bernard Bridge, and the A9. Got to be at the airport by 5:30. I think we can do it. Don't look at me. Everything's gonna be all right.
Away.
Come on. I'll light the fire. I feel better now, don't you? It's good that we slept on the plane. We're home, Hugh. We've won.
We've won.
Now let's take your jacket off. Come on. There we are. Now, come and sit down and we'll have a drink to celebrate. Didn't you want any? What are we going to tell George? Well, he didn't like it when I was here with you before. Maybe now it'll be different. What do you think? You listen to me. You have to help me. I can't do it alone. Look, Hugh, I'm going to say words to you, and you must try and repeat them. Will you try? Good. Now. Now, I want you to try really hard. Say after me. Say after me. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. You say you love me. Say you love me, you. Please, you. Say you love me, you, please. For God's sake, you, speak. Just speak to me, you. Please, just speak to me.
When does a man die? Who knows what happens at the moment of death? The soul doesn't die, simply leaves the body. But what if it didn't? If it went on living in a dead body, a prisoner and a body decaying around it, is it possible? What is possible?
Hugh is not dead.
If it weren't for you, this would never have happened. He's possessed, isn't he? Possessed by you. You're a witch, trafficking with the devil. You have conjured an evil spirit into his dead body.
My love for him has given him life.
It's revolting. His flesh is cold, dead. There is no pulse. No heartbeat. Hugh's body is rotting. It is disintegrating hour by hour, and something must be done now.
Oh, why don't you just go away and leave us alone?
I'll prove it to you. He hears nothing. He feels nothing. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. At the trumpet sound, the grave shall be opened and the dead shall rise again. I know what we must do. We must take him to a priest.
A priest?
Exorcism. Exorcism. This spirit must be exorcised.
And then?
Well, then he can rest. He can be at peace.
He will die.
Yes.
And then it'll be over. Everything.
It will be all right, Anna. Don't stop him.
I can't go with you.
Believe me, it's the best thing for all concerned. He died up there on that beach in Scotland. He died. For now is the axe put unto the root of the trees, so that every tree that beareth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. And the devil was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. For the Lord is come out of his place to visit the wickedness of such as dwell upon the earth. He will purge his flour and gather his wheat into the barn. But he will burn the chaff with unquenchable fire. The day of the Lord cometh as a thief in the night, and when men shall say, peace, and all things are safe, then shall sudden destruction come upon them, and they shall not escape.
struck a bad one since then.
Yeah.
How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I'm not getting too fast for you, am I?
Good. How does it go? How do I love thee? Let me count the ways.
I love thee to the depth and breadth and height my soul can reach. I love thee with the passion put to use in my old griefs. I love thee with the breath, smiles, tears of all my life.
I shall but love thee better after death.
I see something so beautiful. Come with me. Will you be afraid?
Not with you.
We must go there together.
Yes. You love me.
Oh, forgive me for the intrusion, but the door, it was not locked, so... I'm the sentinel for St. Brillat's, Gordon Delamere.
Yes?
Would you be Mrs. Davenant?
Why?
I believe a Mr. Hugh Davenant lives here.
No, there's no one here.
I regret it is my duty to tell Mr. Davenant there has been an accident involving his brother, George Davenant.
Who?
George Davenant. He was killed. In a car crash. It is necessary for the next of kin to identify the body. Where is Mr. Davenant?
He's in Scotland.
Whereabouts in Scotland?
He died there 2 days ago. In Scotland.
Hugh Davenant?
Yes. There. It says there that he's dead. Take it. I'm afraid I can't help you anymore. Now, please go. You'll have to go, please. He's gone. They've all gone.
No one will worry us now. Let's have breakfast. Hmm? No, we can't. It's lunchtime. Well, let's have breakfast anyway. In the morning, will we? Let's go into the moment. morning room. Let's go into the morning room. Come and sit down. And I'll wrap you up. There you are. You are such a darling. There. I'm going to make you the most beautiful breakfast you've ever had. Now that we're really alone. I won't be long. Hope it wasn't too long. Come and sit down. Here. You must be so hungry. Now. It's so difficult when people don't understand. Sad to think of the shop without an owner, though. Maybe when you're really better, you could take it over. We could run it together. Hmm? Well, you know I can't stay at home all day. Hmm? After lunch, I've got to go out and do some shopping. You won't mind being left alone for a little while, will you? Well, you can sit in here and listen to some records. Have you missed me? You.
Anna. Not much time. Come with me. Before I kiss me. Kiss me.
What are you doing?
I'm sorry. I thought that...
There's nobody here. Only me. What do you want?
Nothing. Nothing. I heard about Hugh. And his brother. I'm very sorry.
Sorry?
My father told me, Mr. Delamere, the centenaire.
Your colleague?
Yes. I thought that perhaps if you were alone, I could help. But of course you're not.
I am alone.
But...
There's no one there. There's no one inside. The house is empty. Everything's dead.
Can't I do anything for you?
No. No, there's nothing that you can do. I have to go now. He's calling me. Excuse me.
Will you be all right? Is there nothing I can do for you? I mean...
No, there's nothing that you can do.
Thank you.
Please, Hugh. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it, Hugh. Please, Hugh. Stop loving me. Please stop loving me. Please stop loving me. Just let me go. I don't want to die. I'm sorry. It's my fault. You forgive me.
Thank you.
I thought I saw a man leaving, and I wondered, are you all right now? I brought you some flowers.
I know what I have to do.
Where are you going?
With him. We're going together.
Who? Anna, I don't understand. Anna! Anna, I know something's terribly wrong. Please tell me. If you tell me, I can help you.
Nothing is wrong. Not anymore. Please let me go. You can't follow me there.
Something very wrong, Dad. She said she was alone, but she wasn't. But there was a man there. I saw him leave afterwards. What? No, at El Tico's. Well, I think you should come. Yes. Well, I don't know what to do. Well, yes, I'll be here. Okay.
Till the tide covers the causeway?
Not long.
Is this all there is?
No. It all begins again out there.
Thank you.